I did was try to snap there. That can't be the party. It'll make your swing into a disaster area. So what's it feel like when I snap out there? Ah, yeah, I remember what it feels like. And is the ball in the way of that snap out there? Yep, ball position, distance to ball, levels, and grip club relationship feels pretty good. So what are we doing again? Oh yeah, we're snapping out there. We're gonna use some momentum, go get the snap. I'm going for the snap. Snap, get it out there. Oh, how about that? There it is. Hey everyone, Shawn Clement here, Wisdom in Golf, and boy, do we have an amazing show for you today. Now, throwing is a really big deal because it involves, you know, your legs, it involves the full kinetic chain, it involves the way that your arm is supposed to lead. So what many of you don't realize is when that elbow leads, it flattens or shallows out the club. Now, there are two ways that you can throw. You can throw toward the target or you could throw toward the ball. Now, if you're going to throw toward the ball, this is what it would look like. Recognize that? So notice it's like spiking a football. You're coming over the top. Golf is like a submarine pitch. If I'm going to skip a stone on water, remember that? Notice how my elbow leads on the way through. And we just did a video on that, and it was called Fix Your Swing. And it had everything to do with skipping a stone. So if I underhand it, this is me underhanding it. Notice I'm facing the target. Here's me underhanding one to the ball. Notice how I have to throw it early to go there. Look familiar? So there's your over the top, there's you throwing toward the ball. There's another way that you can get that feel if you're not the best thrower of the ball and throwing has been a little awkward for you. We'll do a different twist on this. We'll become cowboys and cowgirls. So let's look at if I had a little lunge whip here, right? So if I wanted to snap something toward the target, it would look like this. If I wanted to snap something toward the ball, it would look like this. So notice I'd have to flip it this way in order to get to the ball. So every instrument known to man, you know, every instrument known to humanity, pardon me, is designed with handle first in mind. Notice the elbow leads the hand. The hand's got the handle, the handle's coming through way before the club head. So if I'm going fishing, handle first, then the tip of the fishing pole. Baseball, tennis, it's all handle first. Even in the backswing, handle first, follow through, handle first. So if I had a lasso, so if I turn this upside down and I turn this into a lasso, well, here we go. So now look at how I'm using my legs. If this was a heavy rope, I'd have to use my legs and my arm to get that sucker to go around. Now notice how, if I turn it this way, how the elbow is always leading. Elbow, then hand. See how? And then on the way back, the elbow is leading as well. See how the elbow leads? And the elbow leads going through. Notice now, if I wanted to throw this lasso toward the target, throw. Throw. See how that works? See how I'm using my legs? So if you look at this in stop action, you'll notice as I'm initiating, see the it's coming around. And as gravity has it, it's being suspended in the air, then the brain can go to the ground, use the ground to give it the next loop. And you notice when we're doing that, how it's easy to time. So what we want is the ball in the way of that. So if the ball was here on a tee, I'm taking the ball from where it is and I'm collecting it from over here and sending it out into the picture. Send it out there. So I'm never trying to reach back and try to hit the ball. So if you take a golf club now, hold it with one hand, there it is with the golf club. You can feel how you're throwing it in that direction. See how I'm using my legs? The club's coming around, elbow first, hand, then club, then it releases. Now I'm going back this way, so the elbow's pulling back. Snap, snap, wait, snap, wait. Very easy. So now I'm going to take the whip with both hands, snap it out there. Snap it out there. All I need now is the ball in the way of that. Well, guess what? On our premium channel, right now, we're talking about how the ball gets in the way of the task, not in the way of you performing the task. You see what I'm saying? So for many of you, the ball is a mental obstacle. It can't be a physical obstacle. It's way too small. It doesn't weigh enough. So the ball is simply in the way of that twirl. So if I were to do a twirl above the ball, you're going to love this. So now this is how we put it in the way. We need a reference. So if I give it a little bit of a twirl here, yes, I felt the release of my lasso, and I saw that I missed the ball by about that much. So now I get lower. Well, if I perform that same lasso, it feels like I'm going to top the ball. Okay, let's see if I do. So I'm not trying to make sure I'm topping the ball. I want to make sure I get that lasso to release over there. So I'm going to release the lasso. Yes, I released the lasso, and then, hey, look at that. I did top the ball. So it's not about making sure of contact down here. It's about delivering a task. So I am throwing the club into a snap lasso release, and the ball is in the way of that, or it isn't. Many of you are going to have to really close the face at this point, okay? So make sure you see our videos on that. We have tons of videos, even recently. Go to our, you know, YouTube homepage and scroll down and you'll see the titles that, you know, regard closing the face enough to do this so that you can get all the way through the ball. So if I lower myself, so from here I whiff, from here I top, and from here, well, wait a second, it feels like the sole of the club's going to cut some grass. And if that happens, the ball's going to get mashed up against the club face. Can the ball stop me from getting my lasso release? No. It can slow me down a little bit by a couple of milliseconds. That's it. So now I'm going to go get my snap release despite the ball being in the way. So now it feels like the ball is part of that package over there. It did not become the party. You see what I'm saying? You can't let that become the party, the target. That's like me saying, go to your car, and you get to the car and you go, okay, where are we going? I said, nowhere. That's what happens when this becomes your target. So we're going to feel that nice lasso release. When we do, the ball is going to skedaddle out there with it. All right, what's it feel like, that snap lasso release? Oh, yeah, yeah, it feels about like snap. Well, look at here. Way out there, left side of the green, no big deal. And the peak speed felt like it was deep out here. And that's, you know, stock 7-iron now for me, because I started working out. I can't let Sav get, you know, get too close. So I'm back over here at a 194 carry, between 192 and 195. And all I'm trying to do is feel snap out here. Not back here where the ball is, out here where I want the ball to go. Let's do that again. If I snap, I miss. If I snap, I top. If I snap, it's good. Now, what about ball position? Well, I can't snap over there and hit the ball solid. Can't snap over there. Got to reach back. But from here, ooh, that feels like it's in the way of my snap over there. Distance the ball. If I snap over there, I miss. I have to snap over there to get. Got no room to snap. Way too much slack in my lasso. We cannot, and this is so many of you with the longer irons, you can't have a slack in the rope. So as the club gets longer, this is wedge. Notice how vertical it is. This is driver. You can't have the hands at the same distance to your body with all of your clubs. So, where does it want to pass when I perform my lasso out there? Snap it out there. So it wants to pass there. If I snap at the ball, whoo, look out. Shank, dig, pull left, slice right, hang on, early extension, you name it. All I did was try to snap there. That can't be the party. It'll make your swing into a disaster area. So, what's it feel like when I snap out there? Ah, yeah, I remember what it feels like. And is the ball in the way of that snap out there? Yep, ball position, distance to ball, levels, and grip club relationship feels pretty good. So, what are we doing again? Oh yeah, we're snapping out there. We're gonna use some momentum, go get the snap. I'm going for the snap. Snap, get it out there. Oh, how about that? There it is. So, how perfect is that? Started at about 7 degrees right, had a little bit of 1,000 side spin left, it's not a big deal. I'm 6 feet right of my pin. So, we're going out there. The party's out there. You gotta throw the energy out there. You want some fabulous information. Go to wisdomingolfpremium.com. Check out the throwing series. Check out the release videos. Then you're gonna see the kinetic chain engagement or facilitation series. And then we're getting really warm. So the latest series that we're working on right now that is going to come out next week, should be out this week actually, is all about having the ball in the way mentally. It's not in the way. Physically, it's not in the way. The ball is never in the way of your delivery to the target. It's part of the delivery to the target, okay? Get cracking. See you next week.